Hello, my friends, and welcome once again to Can We Help, the show that aims to please by answering your requests. This week, I found out what the word hello and hunting have in common, and whether ice cream contains seaweed. What else? Let's have a look. Why a group of Aussies thought they would find utopia in Paraguay. Can you open your car with your mobile phone?
Go.
An open-heart patient, Josie Joynson, asks Can We Help to locate the pioneering surgeons that saved her life.
Heart's pounding. That's a good start, isn't it?
In 1957, the first successful open-heart operations were performed in Australia. Without such a significant breakthrough, Josephine Joynson, who was five at the time, almost certainly would have died. 50 years on, she's desperate to meet the doctors who saved her life.
I've always remembered being in and out of different hospitals. I was always filled with some kind of fear or terror because they weren't nice places to be.
Josie Joynson was just 3 weeks old when she became seriously ill.
Her birth was normal, and she seemed to be a perfectly happy baby too, till she sort of... I took her to the doctor because she just didn't look right. Nurse came out, took one look at her, and the next thing is Dr. Milliken was there, and he said, straight up to the hospital. And that's it. She was there for 12 months.
Josie was diagnosed with a hole in her heart. Her only hope, major surgery. But back in the early 1950s, the technology to bypass the heart and keep patients alive during surgery simply didn't exist.
However, in the US, specialists were making great advances in cardiac medicine. A roughly drawn sketch of a pioneering heart-lung machine was sent from America to colleagues in Melbourne. And using very basic materials, like PVC piping, the team set about creating this life-saving device.
And it's these doctors Josie wants to find. Through the Australian Medical Association, we've managed to track down Doctors Gardner and Ferguson, two of the original members on the cardiac team.
We simply got this machine, had information about from Lily High, and we put it all together and did it. When we could bypass a dog for 30 minutes or more with reasonable safety, we thought it was appropriate to use the technique on desperately ill human patients.
Open heart operations are routine now, but this was 50 years ago, you know, and we were very proud of doing one success.
March the 28th, 1957, brought a significant medical breakthrough at the Alfred Hospital. A very young boy became the first patient to survive open-heart surgery using the heart-lung machine.
One pump pumping blood out of the patient into the bottom of this tube, oxygen being bubbled in there and then being pumped by another pump back into the patient's arteries, so that the circulation was carried on by this machine instead of the patient's heart.
We're all just looking for the best at the time we knew how serious it was.
The outlook without operation was pretty definite. She didn't have a long life in front of her, so we were giving her a chance.
I remember waking up and they were taking the tubes out, the drainage tubes, and...
Yeah, it was serious.
Yeah, that hurt.
It's 50 years on, and Josie's about to meet the doctors who saved her life.
I remember Dr. Gardner smiled a lot. That really had an impact on me as a child. You know, if a doctor smiled and he was nice to you, he was okay.
Oh, heart's pounding. That's a good start, isn't it?
To see the doctors again after so many years, I could never have imagined. Not in my wildest dreams.
Hello.
Don't be shy.
I remember you.
Lovely to see you.
Oh, wow, I get to say thank
long
you
time
at last.
Long time
later. Behind the scenes, man, you didn't see much.
Well, very much important, don't you worry.
That's right. And you're well?
Fit as a fiddle.
You look pretty fit.
Yeah.
It was very satisfying, actually, to see someone so well, so long after such a...
Coming
procedure.
Up to my 55th birthday month.
We like to see successes.
After the operation, I really made up some ground, and I've done that with my whole life, really.
Despite being advised not to have children, Josie now has five and 16 grandchildren. She's also a singer-songwriter and an award-winning artist. And she's brought with her a gift for the doctors.
This is a painting I did about 6 months ago without any knowledge of we were going to meet, and it's my memories of Ward 15. If it wasn't for the doctors that operated on me, they wouldn't have the advances they have today. And I felt very comfortable about my doctors as a child. I put my faith in them, I put my trust and I believed in them. And they were good doctors because they were making an effort. They were really being doctors and they wanted to heal you.
I have great satisfaction in seeing a patient that we operated on, treated so many years ago, coming forward with children and grandchildren and so on. That gives you personal satisfaction and tells you that what you were doing in the past really was actually worthwhile.
Thank you very much for what you've done.
It's all right.
From the bottom of my heart.
Now, I've said it before, I think we do reunions particularly well on this show. Verity, great work.
Oh, look, and it is exciting stuff too, particularly the historical aspect of, you know, 50 years ago, they were doing open-heart surgery, which I find just extraordinary. But, you know, the other thing I love about this story is that they said, oh, you're not going to have a full life and you won't have children. She had 5 children, 15 grandchildren and another one on the way and, you know, she's lived a long and happy and full life, and that's a great story.
Wonderful work once again. If you need medical help, visit a doctor. But if you want help trying to find someone or something special, write to us at Can We Help ABC TV, GPO Box 9994 in your capital city, or email canwehelp@your.abc.net.au or phone us on 08 9220 2779. Well, that's all the helping we've got time for this week. Thank you very much for your time. Hope you enjoyed the show. Look forward to your company again next time. Thank you very much. Next week on Can We Help, we track down the people who helped political refugee Herbert Bowers rebuild his life.
You don't look much different.
Paleontologist Ken McNamara goes prehistoric, and my powers of recall get put to the test.
And next week on Talking Heads, Wendy Hughes.
I spent a lot of the time naked and doing sex scenes because in the 70s you all had to do that.